Today we're gonna do a right way to add background blur using Snapseed and Lightroom free apps. If you use AI apps, there is a chance of getting these kind of odd results as there is more than a person to be in main focus. Going manual can get better results and you will be in full control. Starting here in Snapseed, we have this picture with a busy background. Also this light pole which we have to consider. Starting with tune image menu, we'll do some basic tuning. Just reducing the brightness a bit. Also adding contrast, bit of reduction in highlights. Next, going to details menu, adding a ton of structure to the overall image. This I will save as a separate copy. I don't need this sharpened effect anymore, so going to view edits and deleting this effect. Now the healing tool. This step is important to the process or else you may get a halo effect around the subject. So zooming in and brushing on the subject and the lamp pole. Fixing this distraction too. No need to be perfect as this will be blurred anyways. This is what we get. Doesn't look too good. But now using the lens blur tool, we are gonna blur it. So here changing from radial to linear option. Making it smaller and placing it around the feet of the subject. Just making sure it is in the right place. So this will be the virtual focal length. Applying it. Now going to double exposure and adding the last saved image. Setting the opacity to 100. Now going to the masking screen. With the image hidden and brush value at 100, roughly brushing to reveal the areas which should be in focus. Now, with the brush value set at 0, zooming in as much as possible and brushing around the edges of the subject to remove these areas so that only the blurred image in the background is revealed. You can toggle to reveal the red mask if necessary. You can go into more detail here, especially masking work. This takes a while, but the results are in your control compared to using AI generating apps. After a few minutes, this is the result with the masking work you can see. Going back an effect before this, I'm gonna add a curves effect and darken the image a bit. Going to the masking screen, applying this darkened effect only on the background. This makes the foreground elements in focus pop more. You can always go back to lens blur and change the blur strength according to your desire. Though for more natural look for this, I'm gonna set it at around 60. We'll export this to Lightroom app for some final tuning. In light menu, increasing blacks and shadows and reducing whites and highlights. In curves, lifting the blacks a bit and tuning overall contrast. Going to color menu, HSL sliders, tuning individual colors, mainly moving reds towards oranges and popping the blues a bit. In detail menu, adding sharpness, making sure to select only the focused areas by dragging the masking sliders. The final result here. Hope this video was useful to you all and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.